by CNN. The message, reportedly from one of the 17 missionaries kidnapped in Haiti. It reads, "Please pray for us. We're being harassed, kidnapped currently. They have control of our vehicle with about 15 Americans right now, ladies, men, and children." He then says they're near Gantier, the place a source in Haiti's security forces confirms is where the group was abducted, 12 adults along with 5 children, according to Christian Aid Ministries. And we're learning more about the gang who may be behind the crime, our source saying it's the 400 Mawozo gang, one of, if not the most powerful in the country, its dozens of members with a distinct hallmark, kidnapping. Nearly a year ago, the gang's alleged leader said, "Me, I work. I'm a gangster. I carry weapons. While I'm in a gang, I have guns. I don't carry weapons to terrorize. Carrying weapons doesn't make me a gangster or a bandit."
Several miles down that road there is where our source in the Haitian security forces says this kidnapping was carried out. And in a more normal situation, we would drive several miles down that road and go see exactly where this took place. But following the advice of both our Haitian producer and our security team, we're not going to go any further than this because they say it's not safe. Down that road is the suburb of Croix-des-Bouquets, which is essentially completely controlled by the 400 Mawozo gang, the gang that authorities say carried out this kidnapping.
That gang and others have terrorized Haiti for years, with kidnappings exploding since January, according to a human rights nonprofit based in Port-au-Prince. Foreigners get the attention, but it's ordinary Haitians that are the vast majority of kidnapping victims, data from the organization shows. This man says kidnappings here have been happening for so long. Why did no one talk about it then? Why is the world making such a big deal about foreigners? It's because they're more important. On Monday, Haitians across the capital region took advantage of the renewed attention by staying home. Schools and businesses and transport services shut down, normally packed Port-au-Prince streets empty. It was a quiet form of protest, people demanding safety and security from a government in turmoil. Nobody is safe, says this man. Even normal people going out to buy food get kidnapped. It's even worse for someone in a car. There is so much fear in the country, even people living outside the country are afraid to come back.